Section 1 Introduction. In this introduction, we dive into the fascinating world of music and its interaction with the human brain. Across cultures, music is a universal language, a profound form of expression and communication. Its mental representation has sparked great interest in the field of neuroscience. In past research, experts studied brain activity in humans, monitored through functional magnetic resonance imaging or fMRI, while subjects listened to music. These investigations unveiled that features such as rhythm, timbre, emotion, and even musical genre are intricately mapped within our brains. The research has provided important insights into how both objective and subjective, acoustic and semantic musical features are reflected in our brain, highlighting the intricacy of our interaction with music. Now, with the arrival of models that convert text into music, the generation of high-quality music has become possible. This thrilling advancement is bridging the gap between our verbal understanding of music and the actual creation of musical compositions. This leads us to ask, how do the text and music embeddings utilized by these music generation models relate to the representations in the human brain? Moreover, if there's a correlation, could we generate music directly from brain activity? In this paper, we test the possibility of creating music from brain activity scans using MusicLM, a language model for music. We also compare some of the internal representations of MusicLM, such as the high-level semantic embedding space of Moulin and the low-level, averaged embeddings from W2V BERT, with activity in different brain areas, offering novel perspectives. Specifically, we make the following contributions. We reconstruct music from fMRI scans by predicting high-level, semantically structured music embeddings and use a deep learning model to generate music from these features. Our tests show that the reconstructed music has a semantic similarity to the original music stimulus. We discover that different parts of our music generation model can forecast activity in the human auditory cortex. The difference between low and high-level audio representations within the auditory cortex isn't as distinct as the one seen in the visual cortex for visual stimuli. We provide fresh insights indicating that within the auditory cortex, there's a significant overlap in the regions that can be predicted from both A. text descriptions of music, and B. the music itself. Section summary. In this section, the authors discuss the representation of music in the human brain and the recent development of text-to-music models. They explore the possibility of reconstructing music from brain activity scans using MusicLM and compare the internal representations of MusicLM to activity in different brain regions. Their findings indicate that the reconstructed music resembles the original stimulus and that there is significant overlap in brain activity between textual descriptions of music and the music itself within the auditory cortex. Section 2 Related Work. In this section, we're exploring the current landscape in music generation models and the intersection of neuroscience with auditory experiences. 2.1 Music generation models creating high-quality music with a sustained consistency over time presents a considerable challenge. The jukebox model was one of the first to address this by using a tiered structure at various time resolutions, modeled using transformer-based models. However, while it produced music with good consistency, there were noticeable imperfections in the output. Perceiver AR, another model, employed SoundStream, a low bitrate audio compression tool, while preserving high-quality reconstruction. Perceiver AR was able to create high-quality audio, but lacked in long-term consistency. Models that use auto-regression and diffusion-based techniques have made significant strides in improving the synthesis quality in music and broader audio generation. AudioLM, for instance, uses a hierarchy of both semantic and acoustic representations to model audio, while MusicLM combines this approach with the Moulin model, which ties in music and text embeddings, allowing for the creation of high-quality music based on detailed textual descriptions. Other notable methods in this realm include transformer-based strategies and the usage of the encodec audio codec. Additionally, diffusion models like Refusion are used in music generation. The versatility of our system, MindMusic, allows us to use MusicLM and its components, but it can adapt to any music generator that can handle conditioning on dense embeddings. 2.2 fMRI audio decoding and fMRI encoding. One of the central aims in neuroscience is understanding how the brain processes sensory and cognitive experiences, and how they are encoded as brain activity. To achieve this, researchers create encoding models to explain how different features of these experiences are transformed into brain activity, and decoding models to infer the experienced content from specific patterns of brain activity. Recent research has revealed similarities between the internal representations of deep learning models and those of the brain across various sensory and cognitive modalities. These discoveries have advanced our understanding of brain functions by A. enabling the creation of encoding models based on these representations, B. interpreting these representations based on their association with brain functions, and C. reconstructing experienced content, such as visual images, from brain activity. In terms of auditory brain functions, researchers have developed encoding models that use deep learning to process auditory inputs. They have also worked on reconstructing perceived sounds from brain activity. However, these studies have largely targeted general sounds, including voices and natural sounds, and have not extended to constructing encoding models that use the internal representations of text to music generative models, or the reconstruction of musical experiences from brain activity focusing on music and its unique features. Section summary. In the field of music generation, previous models like Jukebox and Perceiver AR have focused on producing sensory experiences, but there has been limited research on using text-to-music generative models or reconstructing musical experiences from brain activity. Section 3.1 Music fMRI Dataset. In this section, we explain the process used to compile a dataset related to music and functional magnetic resonance imaging, fMRI. Our approach is based on standard preprocessing methods, further detailed in the appendix. The dataset is centered around music from 10 distinct genres, namely, blues, classical, country, disco, hip-hop, jazz, metal, pop, reggae, and rock. These were randomly selected from the music-only GTZAN dataset. For our purposes, we used 54 pieces of music from each genre, totaling 540 pieces. Each of these pieces was 30 seconds long and sampled at a frequency of 22.05 kHz. Intensity normalized. This resulted in 480 examples for training purposes and 60 to evaluate our final results. As for the MBEPI sequence, a repetition time or sampling interval of 1,500 milliseconds, an echo time of 30 milliseconds, a flip angle of 62 degrees, a field of view of 192 by 192 millimeters, and a voxel size of 2 by 2 by 2 millimeters. Each scanning run captured 410 volumes. To enrich the dataset, we added English text captions to describe the musical pieces. These captions, typically 46 words or 280 characters long, outline the genre, instruments, rhythm, and mood of each piece. Written in a fragmented or semi-complete sentence style, with an average of 4.5 sentences per caption, these captions offer a subjective perspective on the music, not just describing the technical aspects but also the emotional responses they might provoke. Originally written in Japanese, the captions were translated into English using DeepL. Some sample captions and the instructions given to the individuals who wrote them are provided in a separate section. We incorporated these captions to investigate how text-based semantic representations correspond to the brain activity stimulated by the associated music. Section summary. The music fMRI dataset used in this study consists of 540 music pieces from 10 different genres, with each genre having 54 music pieces. Each music piece was randomly sampled from the GTZAN dataset and a 15-second clip was selected from each piece. The dataset was pre-processed by applying fade-in and fade-out effects and normalizing the intensity. During scanning, participants listened to the music clips through MRI-compatible earphones while focusing on a fixation cross. The dataset was augmented with English text captions that describe the musical pieces in terms of genre, instrumentation, rhythm, and mood. These captions were translated from Japanese using DeepL and were used to study the relationship between semantic embeddings derived from the text and brain activity induced by the music stimuli. Section 3.2 Mulan and Music LM. This section discusses two key concepts, Mulan and Music LM. Mulan is a model that maps both text and music into a common space known as embeddings. This model comprises two distinct towers or segments, namely the text tower and the music tower. The text tower, modeled on a language model known as BERT, analyzes and processes text data. For the music tower, we utilize a variation of the RESNET50 model to interpret audio inputs. The goal of Mulan is to optimize the similarity between text and music pairings in this 128-dimensional embedded space. For example, it would aim to ensure that the embedding of a rock song's waveform is close to the text, rock music, and distant from calming violin solo. When we mention a Mulan embedding in this paper, we are typically referring to the music tower's output. Music LM, on the other hand, is a system designed to generate music based on various input signals, which could be text, another piece of music, or a melody. In our process, Music LM receives a Mulan embedding, which we generate based on fMRI brain activity data. We've illustrated the different components of Music LM in a figure within the paper. Music is created in Music LM through two sequential stages. The first stage involves translating a Mulan embedding into a series of tokens from a model called W2V-BERT. We obtain these tokens from the seventh layer of the W2V-BERT model by clustering them. The second stage of Music LM uses these tokens, along with the original Mulan embedding, to generate acoustic tokens derived from a model called SoundStream. We then convert these tokens back into audio with the help of a SoundStream decoder. Like the earlier stages, the second stage is divided into coarse and fine stages, and all stages employ transformer models. The term decoding in this context refers to our efforts to recreate the original stimuli, the music the test subject was listening to, based on their brain activity as recorded by an fMRI scan. This decoding process can be split into two steps. First, we predict the music embedding using the fMRI data, and second, we generate the corresponding music from this embedding. Section summary. The Mulan model consists of two towers, one for text and one for music, and aims to create embeddings that represent the relationship between aligned music and text. The Music LM model is a conditional music generation model that generates music based on various conditioning signals, including text and melody, and is conditioned on a Mulan embedding computed from fMRI responses. The decoding process involves predicting the music embedding from fMRI data and then retrieving or generating music based on that embedding. Section. Music embedding prediction from fMRI data. Dot. Our focus is predicting music embeddings from fMRI data. We'll guide you through this process using some simple terminologies. Think of fMRI responses as a 3D collection, where one dimension refers to the number of music clips, 540 in total. Another dimension refers to the number of fMRI scans taken per music clip, 10 in total. And the third dimension is the number of unique locations, also known as voxels, where the brain responses are measured. This number of voxels varies across individuals because everyone has a unique brain size. For example, for the first participant in our study, it's approximately 60,000. The music embeddings we're trying to predict are based on these stimuli. They're also a 3D collection, but with different dimensions. One dimension is again the number of music clips. Another dimension is the number of embeddings calculated per music clip, and this number depends on the specific model we're using. The third dimension is the size of these embeddings. We aim to match the timescales of the fMRI responses and the music embeddings. To do this, we average out the fMRI responses over specific time windows that correspond to the time ranges for which the music embeddings were calculated. Let's use the Mulan music embedding as an example. Suppose this embedding is computed for a range from 0 to 10 seconds of the music clip. To match this range, we would average 5 fMRI scans covering the same time period in 1.5 second intervals. With this process, we end up with many pairs of averaged fMRI responses and corresponding music embeddings. We then model the relationship between the music embeddings and the fMRI responses using a weighted matrix. The estimated music embeddings are then obtained by multiplying the fMRI response tensor with this weighted matrix. This relationship is modeled using a technique called L2 regularized linear regression, trained on our dataset. However, it's important to note that there's no one-size-fits-all model here since people's brains are anatomically different. The modeling is done independently for each region of interest in the brain, as defined in a standard brain atlas. We selected the top 6 regions of the brain that showed the highest correlation with the music embeddings. These regions varied in size between individuals, but on average they contained approximately 259 voxels. For all the participants in the study, these regions were mostly located in the auditory cortex of the brain. Finally, for every 15-second music clip, we predict a certain number of embeddings, depending on the type of embedding model we've chosen. Section summary. We use fMRI data to predict music embeddings, which are representations of music stimuli. The fMRI data is represented by a response tensor, and the music embeddings are represented by a target tensor. We align the response and target tensors by averaging the response entries in a sliding window fashion. We then use linear regression to estimate the weight matrix that relates the music embeddings to the fMRI responses. Section: Music Retrieval and Music Reconstruction. Dot. We are examining two distinct strategies for recreating the original music from our predicted model, which we denote as T. The first approach is to find similar music from an existing library, while the second is to generate music using a model known as Music LM. For the retrieval process, we use an embedding method called Mulan on the initial 15 seconds of every music clip from the Free Music Archive, a collection boasting a rich variety of over 106,000 music tracks from 161 distinct genres. The retrieved music is the track whose embeddings most closely resemble those predicted by our model, a resemblance determined by cosine similarity. Alternatively, we can generate music using Music LM, a model conditioned on the predicted embeddings. Instead of providing all four embeddings to the model, we average the predicted embeddings, which we found to result in more stable generated outputs. Both methods come with pros and cons. The retrieval method is limited by the size of the dataset, potentially causing loss of information from the predicted embedding. However, the generative model is more flexible, theoretically capable of producing any kind of music within its training scope, including tracks not used as training examples. The downside is that it might not stick closely to the provided embedding. For evaluation, we calculate the identification accuracy of our predicted embeddings relative to their target embeddings. Picture having two matrices of equal size, one with the predicted embeddings, P, and one with the target embeddings, T. We then calculate a matrix, C, from P and T where each cell represents the correlation between the rows of P and T. The identification accuracy is then computed as the proportion of times the predicted correlation is greater than all other correlations. This score, which can range from 0 to 1 with 0.5 suggesting a random guess, quantifies how well an embedding was predicted compared to other embeddings in the dataset. For example, a model with 86% accuracy will, on average, have 14% of candidates scoring higher, that is, correlating better, than the correct candidate. Another metric we utilize is the top N class agreement based on the leaf classifier operating on audio set classes. Here, we calculate the probabilities for original and reconstructed music per class. We then measure the overlap between the top N most probable class labels computed for the original and reconstructed music within three groups of music-related classes, genres, instruments, and moods. Section summary. In this section, the authors discuss two approaches for music retrieval and reconstruction. The first approach involves retrieving similar music from an existing music corpus based on the predicted embeddings. The second approach involves generating music using a Music LM model conditioned on the predicted embeddings. The retrieval approach is limited by the size of the corpus, while the generative model can theoretically generate any kind of music covered by its training distribution. Evaluation metrics include identification accuracy, which measures how well an embedding was predicted compared to other embeddings in the dataset, and top N class agreement, which measures the overlap between the top N most probable class labels for original and reconstructed music. Section 3.4 Encoding, Whole Brain Voxel Wise Modeling. In this section, 3.4, we aim to better understand the inner workings of a model we refer to as Music LM. We do this by observing its relationship with brain activity captured through functional magnetic resonance imaging, or fMRI. Our specific approach involves creating full brain, voxel by voxel models that forecast fMRI signals. These predictions are based on different types of data embedded within the music analyzed by Music LM. Two kinds of embeddings we work with are audio-based, denoted by Mulan caret music, and W2V BERT AVG, and text-based, notated by Mulan caret text. Our initial models aim to predict voxel activity through audio-based embeddings, specifically Mulan caret music and W2V BERT AVG. We're interested in understanding how each of these embeddings is represented differently within the human brain. Subsequently, we build additional models. These ones use both audio-based Mulan caret music and text-based Mulan caret text embeddings to predict fMRI signals. This allows us to investigate the differences between these two kinds of embeddings. Text-based embeddings are particularly intriguing because, by their nature, they can only represent the higher-level information contained in the music caption from which they're computed. The text-based Mulan caret text embeddings we employ correlate 1-to-1 with GTZAN clips. They're created by applying Mulan's text analysis module, a fine-tuned version of the BERT model, to the text caption of a given GTZAN clip. Examples of such captions can be found in a subsequent section. We also carry out a control analysis to ascertain whether Moulin Carrot music encompasses more than just genre information. This involves comparing the prediction capabilities of the Moulin Carrot music model against one hot vectors of music genres for each GTZAN clip. To prepare the training data, we follow the same process as we do in decoding, detailed in a previous section. In essence, the modeling problem we're dealing with here is the reverse of a previous equation, where we predict fMRI responses based on different embeddings. We calculate the weights of our model from training data and explore different regularization parameters during the training process. We do this using a technique known as five-fold cross-validation. The weights are then applied to the test data. We assess the performance of our models by calculating the Pearson correlation coefficients between the predicted and actual fMRI signals. We determine the statistical significance of these correlations by comparing them to a null distribution. This distribution represents the correlations between two independent random variables, assuming a Gaussian distribution and having the same length as our test data. We've set our threshold for statistical significance at a p-value of less than 0.05, with corrections made for multiple comparisons using the FDR procedure. Lastly, for Moulin Carrot text and one hot music genre vectors, we perform an upsampling process to align with the sampling rate of Moulin Carrot music. Section summary. In this section, the authors explain how they analyze the internal representations of their music LM model by comparing them to recorded brain activity. They use different types of embeddings derived from audio and text to predict fMRI signals and explore the differences between them. They also conduct a control analysis to determine if the audio-derived embeddings capture more than just genre information. The model weights are estimated using linear regression and evaluated using Pearson's correlation coefficients. Statistical significance is determined using a threshold of p less than 0.05, and multiple comparisons are corrected using the FDR procedure. Section: Music Embedding Prediction. Dot. We are working on converting brain signals, or fMRI data, into music. To do this, we first need to predict a middle step, a kind of musical code or music embedding, as illustrated in our model. The effectiveness of our final music generation relies heavily on this embedding. If we can accurately predict music embeddings that closely match those of the original music stimulus heard by the person, we'll be successful in creating music that resembles the original piece using our music language model. Music LM. However, the quality of this reconstruction is also limited by what the embedding itself can encapsulate. We tested different types of embeddings and found that Moulin music embeddings were the most accurately predicted from fMRI signals, outperforming Moulin text, W2V BERT AVG, and Soundstream AVG embeddings. This was evident in both the correlation and identification accuracy. There might be a few reasons for this. 1. Both Moulin text and music embeddings, based on their listed properties, might align better with the abstract level of fMRI data than the other types of embeddings. 2. Our approach to correlating W2V BERT and Soundstream embeddings with the fMRI data might not be the most effective and could benefit from further analysis. 3. Moulin music embeddings carry more musical information than Moulin text embeddings as they are derived directly from the audio signal. Given these results, we focused on using the fMRI data to predict Moulin music embeddings, which we'll simply call Moulin embeddings, for the rest of this study. We then used these embeddings to recreate the original musical stimulus. We also included W2V BERT AVG in our evaluation for comparison. Regarding qualitative reconstruction results, we explored two methods of reconstructing music: retrieving from the Free Music Archive, FMA, and generating with Music LM. The comparison showed that both methods yielded music that was semantically similar to the original stimulus in terms of genre, vocal style, and overall mood. However, they often did not preserve the temporal structure of the original stimulus, and there were instances where the reconstructed music was from a completely different genre. Comparing the results across five different subjects, we found that the quality of the reconstruction was fairly consistent, suggesting that our method is robust. This is significant given the potential variation in individual experiences when dealing with fMRI data. Section summary. In order to generate music from fMRI data, we need to predict an intermediate music representation called music embeddings. The accuracy of predicting these embeddings from fMRI signals varies depending on the type of embedding used, with Moulin, Carrot, text, music embeddings showing the highest correlation and identification accuracy. Using these predicted embeddings, we can reconstruct the original stimulus, although the temporal structure of the music is often not preserved. However, overall, our method shows consistent and robust reconstruction quality across different subjects. Section. Quantitative Reconstruction Evaluation. Dot. We're now assessing the efficacy of our music reconstruction. The figure provides key quantitative results. To gauge how similar the reconstructed music is to the original piece, we're using two key measurements. Identification accuracy, which we use for two different types of semantic embeddings, and agreement with AudioSet's top N class. We've also created a benchmark to help understand the maximum possible quality we could achieve by retrieving music from the Free Music Archive, FMA. This benchmark is an Oracle predictor, which essentially bypasses the linear regression process and retrieves an FMA clip based directly on the original music stimulus Mulan embedding. This is essentially a simulation of the performance we'd expect if our prediction from fMRI scan to Mulan was flawless. To contrast, we also show the performance of a model that randomly selects samples from FMA. This is what we refer to as the chance result. Our findings so far have been promising. The results are significantly better than what would be achieved by chance, in all metrics we're considering. This is a good sign that we can reliably extract musical information from fMRI scans. We compared the identification accuracy across different types of embeddings and found that the reconstruction is closest to the original music when we consider high-level semantic features, captured by Mulan. This might seem expected, as we're targeting Mulan in our predictions, but it's not a given that the high-level semantic information related to perceived music would even be present in the brain responses we're recording. On the other hand, the presence of low-level information in the reconstruction is gauged by the identification accuracy on an averaged version of the word 2-vet-bird, W2VBERT-AVG. It's important to note, however, that the results are influenced by the averaging we perform on the W2VBERT to match the temporal resolution of the embeddings with that of the fMRI scans. Even with this in mind, the numbers seem consistent with what we've qualitatively observed. Low-level, acoustic features aren't as well aligned, while the overall music style is. Furthermore, we saw consistent prediction performance across different musical genres, as labeled in the GTZAN dataset. The highest accuracy was achieved with classical music, likely because of its unique musical style. Section summary. The authors conducted a quantitative evaluation of their music reconstruction method using two measures, identification accuracy and AudioSet top N class agreement. They compared the reconstructed music to the original stimulus and found significant above chance performance, indicating their ability to extract musical information from fMRI scans. The results suggest that the reconstruction is most faithful to high-level semantic features captured by the Mulan embedding, while low-level acoustic features are relatively less aligned. The method also showed consistent prediction performance across different music genres, with the highest accuracy achieved on classical music. Section. Comparison between different audio-derived embeddings. Dot. We'll be comparing different types of audio-derived embeddings used in our encoding models. Specifically, we're looking at the prediction accuracy of two types, Mulan and W2VBERT-AVG. These embeddings help us represent music in our music language model, MusicLM. What we found is that the Mulan embeddings generally outperformed the W2VBERT-AVG ones, especially in the lateral prefrontal cortex area of the brain. This implies that Mulan is better at encapsulating the more complex aspects of music that our brains process. However, when we focus on the auditory cortex, an area of the brain responsible for processing auditory information, both types of embeddings show some degree of correlation with the brain activity in that region. This is intriguing because the text music model we used in our study wasn't designed to mirror the brain's workings as closely as previous deep learning models, such as convolutional neural networks. Also interesting is the fact that although Mulan and W2VBERT-AVG represent different levels of complexity in audio-derived embeddings, with Mulan being higher and W2VBERT-AVG lower, they predicted quite similar regions within the auditory cortex. Our findings also show a substantial overlap between the brain regions well predicted by these two types of embeddings. What we can infer from this is that, unlike the visual cortex, the auditory cortex doesn't show a strong hierarchical differentiation in the processing. Of these audio-derived embeddings, contrary to previous assumptions. But bear in mind, our results might be skewed by the fact that we average the embeddings for W2VBERT. You can also refer to the limitations discussed in another section of our paper for more context. We've provided additional results for all subjects we studied in the paper's figures. Moving on to a comparison between audio and text-derived Mulan embeddings. From earlier, we know that the hierarchical differentiation within the auditory cortex wasn't as strong with respect to audio-derived embeddings. Next, we wanted to see how differently the abstract, text-derived information about music was represented in the auditory cortex compared to the audio-derived embeddings. We found that for some subjects, Music is represented more strongly in the inner side of the brain fold, the sulcus, than the outer side. But the functional differentiation in the brain still seems to be modest. It's important to note that although we aim to make these two types of embeddings match, because of the varied nature of text and music pairings, achieving a perfect match was not feasible. However, from a neuroscience perspective, our study shows that Mulan music and Mulan text embeddings end up with quite similar representations. Again, we found a significant overlap between the well-predicted brain regions for both types of embeddings. All these results suggest a closer correlation between the various types of embeddings than initially expected. Section summary. The comparison between different audio-derived embeddings in the study revealed that Mulan embeddings outperformed W2V BERT AVG in predicting high-level music information in the lateral prefrontal cortex. However, both embeddings showed some correspondence with human brain activity in the auditory cortex, suggesting that there is not a strong hierarchical functional differentiation of audio-derived embeddings in this region. Additionally, the study found that text-derived Mulan embeddings and audio-derived Mulan embeddings acquired fairly similar representations in the brain, despite the objective of matching text and music pairings not being achieved perfectly. Section 4.3 Generalization Beyond Music Genre. In this section 4.3, we extend our research to examine if our model can also be applied to music genres that were not included in the initial training phase. To achieve this, we purposefully exclude a single genre during training and then measure the accuracy of genre identification using clips from the left-out genre, which were part of the test set. As figure depicts, our model demonstrated substantial proficiency, much higher than mere chance, in identifying these unseen music genres. This evidence supports the idea that our reconstruction method can successfully expand beyond the genres we initially trained it on. Additionally, we contrast the predictive performances of the music and genre models of Mulan to test if our encoding model retains information that exceeds just music genres. Our findings suggest that the musical embeddings from Mulan predict activity in the auditory cortex more widely and with greater precision, as shown in figure, when compared to the vectors of music genres. This finding provides additional support that our model can forecast more than just genre-specific information. Further results for all subjects are illustrated in figure. Let's discuss some limitations. The advanced music generation model we utilize translates a Mulan embedding into a piece of music. Any information not contained within the embedding, but needed for the music clip generation, is supplied by the model. When it comes to retrieval, the reconstructed music is guaranteed to be melodious since it is directly derived from a music dataset. While this results in highly impressive, human-friendly outputs, it may also imply a level of reconstruction quality that might not actually exist. Three primary factors can potentially limit the quality of reconstruction. 1. The extent of information we can derive from the fMRI data using linear regression. 2. The capability of the chosen music embedding, in this case, Mulan, to capture relevant data. 3. The constraints associated with music retrieval, such as the size and diversity of the dataset, or the capabilities of the generative model. We explore the limitations of factors 1 and 2 by predicting brain activity for different types of embeddings. By indicating the maximum achievable performance as a dashed line oracle in figure, we separate factors 2 and 3 from factor 1. For instance, given the use of the Mulan embedding and the FMA retrieval dataset, the agreement on moods cannot exceed 78%. To understand the variability of factor 3, we experiment with three distinct reconstruction methods, which involve two sizes of FMA for retrieval and one generative model. However, the detailed examination of factors 1, 2, and 3 is still an open question. Another limitation of this study is the coarse temporal sampling rate of the fMRI, which in this case was 1.5 seconds. Nevertheless, even with a 2.5 second fMRI sampling rate, previous studies have demonstrated temporal specificity at 200 milliseconds by using patterns from multiple voxels. Different voxels might hold information about various frequency bands, collectively contributing to this result. The amount of information that can be effectively retrieved from fMRI data will be the subject of future research. A potential misinterpretation is that the term music reconstruction may imply a direct loss between the original music stimuli and the reconstructed music. Given the limited data available, such an assumption is not feasible in our scenario. We utilize the term music reconstruction to describe the overall system, but one could argue that the actual target for reconstruction is Mulan. At present, we don't have a clear path to achieve end-to-end music reconstruction using fMRI data. Lastly, the temporal averaging of soundstream and W2V BERT embeddings likely reduces their expressiveness. The role these embeddings play in music LM differs from their application here in terms of temporal resolution. We indicate this by adding the suffix AVG to these embeddings whenever their averaged versions are used. Determining the type of information these averaged embeddings contain and further evaluating music similarity measures are the next steps. This applies to both our encoding and decoding studies. Section summary. The authors investigate whether their model can generalize to music genres that were not used during training. They find that their model performs significantly above chance on unseen music genres, suggesting that their reconstruction method is able to generalize beyond the genres present in the training data. Additionally, they compare the prediction performances of their model to test whether it captures information beyond music genres and find that it predicts activity in the auditory cortex more broadly and with higher accuracy, indicating that it may predict beyond just music genre information. However, there are limitations to the reconstruction quality due to factors such as the amount of information that can be extracted from fMRI data, the capabilities of the chosen music embedding, and the limitations of the music retrieval or generation processes. The authors also note that the temporal averaging of certain embeddings may affect their expressiveness, and further research is needed to determine the information contained in these embeddings and evaluate their performance on other measures of music similarity. Section: Future work. Future endeavors. Our current research involves the recreation of music based on fMRI signals, which were collected as individuals listened to musical stimuli through headphones. Looking ahead, we're eager to take this study a step further. One intriguing possibility is reconstructing music or its features purely from an individual's imagination. In this scenario, a participant would visualize a familiar piece of music, while we analyze how accurately this imagined rendition can be reconstructed. This domain remains unexplored and could truly be deemed as mind reading. Another compelling direction for future research involves examining the variation in reconstruction capabilities among individuals with diverse musical backgrounds. A comparative analysis of the quality of reconstruction between, for instance, professional musicians or conductors and those with minimal self-claimed musical exposure could provide fascinating insights into the nuances of individual perception. Section summary. In future work, we can explore the reconstruction of music or musical attributes from a subject's imagination, which would be a significant advancement in mind reading. Additionally, comparing the reconstruction quality among subjects with different musical expertise, such as professional conductors or musicians versus those with minimal music experience, could provide insights into differences in subjective perception.